Hey everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the arc length of a parametric curve. And in this particular problem, we've been given two equations that define our parametric curve as always. One equation for x, and we've been given x equals 2t, and one equation for y equals 2/3 t to the 3/2. And remember that with parametric curves, you always have an equation for x and y that are both defined in terms of a parameter, t. So we've got t in both of these equations. And those two equations together make up a single parametric curve. So in order to find the arc length of a curve, remember we learned how to do arc length before, but when we had one function. Now we've got two equations, so we have to rationalize that somehow, getting those two equations into an integral so that we can find arc length. So this is going to be the arc length formula that we're going to use when we have these two parametric equations. S is going to represent arc length, and we have to integrate on the range A to B. A and B are going to be defined by the range we've been given in our problem. We've been asked to find the arc length from 5 to 12 when t is between 5 and 12. So we've got A and B here, and then the square root of 1 plus dy over dx squared. So this is our formula. The only other pieces of information that we need to know are that when we're dealing with parametric equations, your x equation you can think of as f of t, and this is commonly the way that parametric equations are defined. So f of t is going to be your x equation. G of t is going to be your y equation. So that means that if x is equal to f of t, right? If x is equal to f of t, then that means that dx, the derivative of x, is going to be f prime of t. Similarly, if y is equal to g of t, then the derivative of y, which is going to be dy, is equal to g prime of t. So that makes sense. And in fact, these are going to be f prime of t dt and g prime of t dt, because we took the derivative with respect to t, so we've got to add that dt. So we're going to use these values to plug in for dy and dx into our integral. So let's go ahead and start working on arc length. So we're going to take the arc length from A to B, which we already know to be from 5 to 12, on the range 5 to 12. We're going to take the square root of 1 plus the quantity dy over dx. So to find dy, we know that we need to take the derivative of our y equation. So we've got y equals 2/3 t to the 3/2. So that means y prime, or dy, is going to be 2/3 times, we bring that exponent down, so times 3/2 t to the 3/2 minus 1, right? That's how we take a derivative. So y prime, obviously 2/3 times 3/2 is equal to 1, so that's going to cancel, and we'll just be left with t to the 1/2. So dy is equal to t to the 1/2. So we can go ahead and plug in t to the 1/2 in for dy. Then we're going to divide that by dx, and to find dx, we'll take the derivative of our x equation. So x prime, or dx, will be the derivative of 2t, which is simply 2. So dx is going to be equal to 2. And remember that when we take the derivative, we have to put in dt, right? So we've actually got dt in both the numerator and the denominator here. Dt gets added to this equation for y prime, and dt gets added to this equation for x prime. Obviously, those are just going to cancel each other out of the fraction. But we square that according to our formula, and then we plug in for dx, which we already know to be 2 dt. So we plug in 2 dt. All right, so now we can do a couple of things. First of all, we can cancel dt, right? So we don't need that anymore. We can also bring this 2 out in front of the integral because it's a constant that's just multiplied by everything else inside of the integral. So we'll end up with s equals 2 times the integral from 5 to 12 of the square root of 1 plus, now let's look at squaring t to the 1/2 over 2. We can deal with the numerator and the denominator separately. So when we square t to the 1/2, right, when we do t to the 1/2 times t to the 1/2, we multiply exponents, or sorry, we multiply terms where the base is the same, right? The base here, they're both equal to t. When that occurs, we add the exponents. So you add these together, 1/2 plus 1/2 is equal to 1. So you actually end up with t to the first power, t to the 1, which is just t. So we get t here. And then when we square the denominator, 2, obviously that's just 4. So we end up with t over 4 here inside of our square root, and then we just have dt hanging out. So now we want to go ahead and find a common denominator underneath the square root if we can. And in order to do that, we'll just turn this 1 into 4 over 4, right? That's exactly the same thing. 4 divided by 4 is just 1. So we haven't changed anything at all, but now we've got a common denominator. So S is going to be 2 times the integral from 5 to 12 of the square root of 4 plus t divided by 4. And this is helpful because you can take the square root of the numerator and denominator separately, and we know the square root of the denominator, 4, to be 2. So that means we'll be able to bring it outside. So we'll end up with S equals 2 times the integral from 5 to 12 of the square root of 4 plus t over 2 dt, right? So we took the square root of the numerator and the denominator separately, and we just went ahead and left the numerator as 4 plus t because we don't really know how to take the square root of that, but we know how to take the square root of 4, and it's 2. These terms here now are going to cancel these two 2s right here. So now we're just left with the integral from 5 to 12 of the square root of 4 plus t, which we can call 4 plus t to the 1/2 dt. Remember that the square root of x is the same thing as x to the 1/2, so we can just change that. Now we can easily take the integral. So what we do is we add 1 to the exponent, we add 1 to 1/2, and 1/2 plus 1 is 3/2, so then we divide the coefficient by 3/2, so we'll get 1 over 3/2, 4 plus t to the 1/2 plus 1, which is 3/2, right? And then we're going to be evaluating this on the range 5 to 12. So let's go ahead and simplify. We'll end up with, instead of 1 over 3/2, we'll get 2/3 times 4 plus t to the 3/2 on the range 5 to 12. And when we're dealing with a definite integral, we plug in the upper limit of integration first. So we'll plug in 12 first. We'll get 2 over 3. 12 plus 4 is 16, so we get 16 to the 3/2 minus what we get when we plug in our lower limit of integration. So 2/3, 5 plus 4 is 9 to the 3/2. So now we can evaluate 16 to the 3/2 easily. We will first, basically this is the same thing as saying 16 to the 1/2, and then raised to the third. We can split up this exponent. Instead of 3/2, we'll call it 1/2 times 3. We're going to deal with the 1/2 part first because anything raised to the 1/2 is the square root of that same thing. So basically, taking the square root of 16 deals with this part right here. So the square root of 16 we know to be 4. Then we take 4 and we raise it to the third power, 4 to the third power. So 4 times 4 is 16, times 4 is 64. So we end up with 64. So 16 to the 3/2 is 64. And then we do the same thing over here again. We can first deal with the square root, which is this 1/2 here. 9 to the 1/2, or the square root of 9, is 3. And then we take 3 and raise it to the third power. 3 to the third power is 27. So 9 to the 3/2 is 27. So now 2 times 64 is 128 over 3. 2 times 27 is 54. So 128 minus 54 all over 3, since we've got that common denominator that we can use. And 128 minus 54 is 74. So our final answer is 74 over 3. That is the arc length of this parametric curve on the range 5 to 12. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.